Hi, I'm Ryan. I'm at DBS Bristol and I'm doing a workshop on mixing Atmos in film. So yeah, Atmos. So I think the difference in Atmos is we're working in object-based audio. And what's cool about it is you can take objects and place them anywhere. And the difference between 5.1 and 7.1, while we still have stems, you've kind of got a bed, which I think is kind of explained in the name. You know, it's the bed of audio, it's the channels which we have speakers for, and then the objects are, they come with panning automation and they're like a separate entity, and you can basically pan them, they, you know, go into the height. So that's the biggest thing. Before, in 7.1, you could send things to different speakers, you can pan them to different speakers, but you couldn't add height, and which is the, you know, the biggest difference now. With that comes the RMU, which if I just move to a bit in the film where there's some objects, I'll put this, I'm just going to play a little bit here, but you'll be able to see on the RMU. Yeah, so as you can see, the RMU with the little green dots, these are all little things which, objects have all got panning automation, they're all kind of doing different things in the mix. So in terms of the disciplines, I would say like one of the biggest advice I could give you is from a very early stage of working as a sound editor or a mixer is getting into the idea of like keeping those things separated. It's very common as like a deliverable that you have to make an M&E, which is called like, it's like music and effects, and they use it a lot for localization. Like big shows and films will get, they'll get dubbed. And so for instance, when my work at Pinewood, one of the main parts of my job is localization mixing. So yeah, we'll basically get an M&E, and then we'll get sent dialogues from all around the world, and we'll mix those to work in the film and work with that M&E. So yeah, it's very important to kind of learn to get into that mode of I want to be able to get a point where my session I can easily split out dialogue, music, and effects. So yeah, in terms of beds and objects, I guess the easiest way we'll go through Pro Tools and I'll kind of explain how some of this works. I'm gonna have to move some things around. And just to show you in here, I'll just show you like my bus page for these big sessions. So like my bus page for this session is like massive. in terms of what's like going on here, you've got a, so the RMU works with beds and objects. So I've got, as you can see here, I've got dialogue, music, effects, backgrounds, Foley beds, which then feed into the RMU. So these are the beds and these are the numbers for the objects. And then there's some very complicated stuff going on, but you have like dialogue objects, music objects. The way we've done it in this template is we have, has everyone heard of Halo Upmix? So yeah, you can basically take like stereo tracks and upmix them up into surround and stereo. So typically with a short film, you would get a lot of stereo tracks. So if you want it to work in surround, you need to use an upmixer. And it does a bunch of stuff, which is, I'm not gonna try and explain, but it makes it sound good and it works in surround. And so what we've done in this, for instance, is we've upmixed it to 5.1. But then we've made the 5.1 outputs objects, so we can move like LCR at the front, we can have these, and for this all work, you've got to really understand like how the busing works. You know, your ins and outs have all got to be right, and you know, something's going to the wrong channel, and you're like, oh, what's, you know. So it's definitely, yeah, it's not very exciting, but definitely get used to like sending tone through channels and be like, oh, I'm 100%, like this is all going in the right way. And in terms of setting up your sessions, you know, I find just like top to bottom signal flow, follow, you know, starting here and it ends here, and just make life easy for yourself. So in terms of my session, we have this all split up into, so this is dialogue, crowd, score, which is music, effects, backgrounds, Foley. So since Pro Tools brought in these nice folders, you can keep everything nice and neat. In terms of the dialogue, this is what's happening in the dialogue session. So what we have is a bunch of dialogue tracks, and they're split into dialogue, PFX, which is for like production effects. So sometimes, like in modern film editing, generally the dialogue gets so cleaned up, there's like nothing left in there. But in terms of like smaller projects, lower budget stuff, if they haven't got a huge Foley budget, you want to keep as much as the production sound as possible, because otherwise someone's going to have to sit and replace all the footsteps and all that kind of stuff. So always keep that on a separate track, again, because it's good for like making M&Es and things like that. Keep it separate. Same with your ADR. If you get into dialogue, the biggest kind of challenge is getting somebody talking in a studio matching someone who's like out in a street, or they're in a warehouse and then you're in a nice treated studio, and you keep those separate because they have to have a lot of processing and tweaking to get them to work together. Then in terms of objects, my template, we actually have all the objects as dedicated tracks. There's a feature in Pro Tools where you can automate an output to go from an output or to an object. So if you don't want to have, if you want to have less tracks, you can do that. I personally don't like it because I've definitely like had problems with it before where it doesn't switch when it should. So I always keep all my objects as, completely separate. So it's its own track. The output goes to its object, and then I can do all the panning and everything that I want. We've got, sent everything to the buses, which if I, where's my mix page? Try and find this mouse. What's it? There we go. So in terms of what's going on with the tracks, every mixer, editor, everyone will have their own kind of workflow and what to do. So this is just how I do it. But all these tracks go to a bus. So it's very easy to kind of keep tabs of what's going on. And in terms of processing, my dialogue tracks have like a bunch of stuff going on, and then they go to a dialogue bus, and same for PFX and everything else. And then that way, in terms of like when you're leveling and mixing, you know, you're for instance, like on the tracks and stuff, your dialogue might be sounding all right, but you might want to just bring the whole thing up a bit. So that's why we've got buses. And then from there, you've got all your reverbs. So yeah, this is generally in this one. So this is, because everything runs in one template, it's obviously like this, I mean, this machine is pretty good, but if you go into like an older Mac Pro, this would like struggle to run this because there's so much going on. So this is like a very kind of, very low maintenance session. But sometimes on like big productions, you would literally have like a Mac Pro just for dialogue. You'd have one for effects, one for music, and then you can have all the reverbs and everything you want. So this is like a very simple cut down version. So we have like two stereo verbs, have a surround verb, and we also have a delay on there, and then an LFE chain for any kind of low sub content.